before Java, and it is now the de facto language of the machine learning. There are no other language which can compete with machine learning, and you know the machine learning is one of the prosperous field of computer science. So machine learning will be a subject, definitely we'll try to touch certain topics of machine learning programming with Python 3. Without machine learning, no use of Python 3, only regular data structure jobs. Python is okay, Python is, you can understand it well because it's less code. So with Giri Van Rassen is there, and he is the de facto maintain all the standard, and he developed the language whenever he was in BTech second year or some third year. In fact, our professors voted him to appear for the exam, so he's so involved in his job. So that's it. So Python is, main beauty lies in the Python is Python code. It should be very much readable. That is the reason the semicolon and the second bracket opening and closing is not there. So indentation is a must. Indentation is not optional here. And indentation, you all know the Python indentation is very looks beautiful, the program. Actually, any program, it's developed by one or maybe few, but it's generally rated by a thousand or maybe hundreds. So programmers' times are more costly than the CPU time. So the Python is the first language towards making it more readable. The readability for sort of thing is the Python is. It is not machine friendly that way, but doesn't matter because machine is very cheap now. Memory is cheap. Right now, due to lockdown and all these things, maybe certain semiconductor industry have high prices. But anyway, it will be further. It will not rise further. So Python is a great language. So why is Python? That is, you please see my earlier video. So today I just to see certain things, features of Python. Yeah. So anywhere you do not just see. Python is a virtual machine concept. It's same like Java, but it is much better than Java because Java is a verbose language. You have to write a lot of codes. So that's it. Main thing I have to discuss the Python here. This is the data structure portion of C language. There's anywhere you cannot escape C and Java. Whatever language you next your career, maybe another one or two language you may have to cover, like SQL you have to cover, like maybe like this, you have to compare with others. So data structure is very vital thing. Probably you are now exposed to data structure. Is data structure how you put your data in various data structure, and if you have efficient data structure is available, then your program complexity will be less. So say whole programs, if you take is a whole program, it is governed by algorithm. So program algorithm dictates which program, then program, there is one top part the coding and data, you know, any program, the top part is the coding and data is the later part, and the data, if you put it in an intelligent structure, and then your program length will be shorter, and whenever the program length will be shorter, there will be less bug, and development type is quick. So data structure in Python is much powerful. We can, let's compare with the C. C data structure all are mutable, that is all are changeable, but you know in Java and Python we have a immutable data structure, like a string, like a tuple, like a frozen set. Immutable data structure is very useful, like in real life, that if somebody's name is, my name is Shomnath, it will not be changed hopefully in the next 30-40 years. So it is better to put in immutable data structure so that I can copy it from hither and thither with very efficient code. So any string operation, generally it is found that if it is an immutable data structure, that is good. Java has immutable data structure. C doesn't have any immutable data structure. That is a weakness of C. C has several weaknesses. That is one of them. Because C, at what time it is developed, that is, the memory is too costly. It is 1961 and 62 by Dennis Ritchie and Carnegie and Pike. At that time, memory is too costly. So they always think of reuse the memory, but memory is now less costly. We have 8 GB, 16 GB RAM. So string, so you can have use and throw string. So whenever you don't want to, we want to change a string, we just copied it. That is much faster. So, and we don't have pointer here. Pointer is all concern of what it gives all the problem with C. So have this is the C data structure. So we don't have C here. We forget about C. The Python. Let's compare with the Python. Python, the main strength lies a mutable data type, that is like C, and immutable data type, unlike C. Immutable data type, all numbers and whatever you see is immutable. Strings are immutable, tuples are immutables. They are great advantage. They are faster in operation, and you have another new type of data type is dictionary, least, and all these things. Like here, mutable is least. It is unlike array. In an array, you have same kind of things in least, in many kinds of things. So definitely, it will be slower. And there's great is a dictionary. Dictionary, the left hand portion is a key. Key can be any immutable type, and right hand side any value. So dictionary will come. Sets is there. Frozen set comes here, immutable. So these are the very flexible data structure is there. So now your program is much simpler. And if data comes to intelligent structure, data behaves better, program can be shorter. Lots of IDEs are there. You can choose any IDE. I personally take the Colab is my favorite choice, because every commands works here. You don't have to do anything. How to open Colab? It is nothing but you open your Gmail, and on the right hand tab, you just write Google Colab. You search it and you click it. You will go to your Colab window, this window, just instantaneously. So it's absolutely easy. You don't have to load anything, nothing. You just have to log in only Gmail, and you have to just open a tab and you search Google Colab. You just click it, you will go into it, and then you just file new command, you write it. Anything. So same way you can do it. We land up in a Google Colab, and you just write printf hello world. This is the standard, and it will run it. You might ask why it is slow, because it is connecting to a machine there. Yeah, it is comes. First time it will be slower, but next time it will be faster. Yeah, because it is connected to a remote machine. What is the advantage is there? You will get a 12 GB machine with not only CPU, with a GPU. You probably know what is GPU is for graphics processing, and another is a TPU, tensor processing unit, will be free, and that will be free for 12 hours. And you can connect to it from any machine. So this is the just a hello world command is running, and you know this is the comment, this is only comment. You all know these things. Then we go to the, this is favorite command I find. You can check which version you are working. So this is the version it is running. And another thing is the Python has some peculiarity. I1 is equal to 12, print type of I1, print ID I1, print I1, and if you put I1 there, and if you put also, like if you put I2 equal to 12, and I say print ID, yes, if you just follow it, copy selection, I just type it, print ID 2. Yeah, it is not required. Yeah, not required. So just run this code. See, you see it, ID I1 and ID I2 is same. It is peculiarity of Python. Why the Python have done it? They done it from the, because they have the same values. So that is, it is the, they have given the same pointers kind of address. This is not pointer, this is kind of address. And this is of no use. It is, but if you change it here, instead of 12, 13, then it should change. Then it is CFC change. Okay. So right now, go ahead little bit, then I will take more questions. This is a say simple whether 5 greater than 2 or not. See if structure 5 and then colon here. So yes, 5 is greater than 2. It is a because if you say 5 is greater than 6, definitely it will fail, and this thing will not be executed. Yeah, this little thing will not be executed. The typical if loop, that is if structure, there is no opening close, there is no bracket here. just see there is a colon here and there should be indentation. Indentation must be 2 character or 4 character, it is better. You can maintain indentation 1, but it is better 2. Okay, let's go certain new things today, whichever is not covered in earlier classes also. So it's a single linked list. Today probably you are on data structure classes. So how to create a single linked list? First I created a class. It is object-oriented programming. Python supports both object-oriented programming and procedural programming. Whenever I am creating a single linked list, I need a object of type node, and another I object, I need a single linked list. So I am creating a class of node. So this is a class, the keyword, and there's a method. Definitely this is a constructor method of that node. The constructor is __init__, and this is the self is here, means kind of a Java this, that I want to put certain value into this, and this is the value I want to initialize with. So self.data, whatever value I can give, and this is the next level of address. It is kind of pointer, not exactly C like pointer. This is a class linked list, and I initialize the node. Okay, and there's a method def. In Python, here we generally don't call function, it called a method, and or you can say define is a keyword. Whenever you see the define, then def, that is a, you are declaring a function, new function, and there is always a semicolon here, and indentation is there. Here is indentation is 4 character. So in your code, you just try it in 4 character or 2 character. 4 character is definitely better. So that's it. So here we have a printing. Now I am starting the code. Like I print first a single linked list. I'm instantiation object. Say in Java it will be new class, but here no new is there. It is just a linked list. This is the class name. I'm just repeating the class name. Then a object of list will be created, and then this particular one object I initialize with node 5, node 6. I can make it say initially we can make it node 1, node 2, initially with value 2, yep, initialize with value 3, initialize with value 4, and we just check the run the code. We can see that it is a single linked list and the value is 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't worry, this code I have taken from various sources. I just copy and paste, hardly change anything. I think Geeks for Geeks, the code is available. These also will be shared to you. One I think I must tell you, then don't try to write the code from the scratches. You just get copy and paste it, but try to understand the code. In case you do not understand the code, you just throw the code. Whatever code you understand, you put it and run it. Yeah, I am now available for questions. Any questions? Now tell me who has asked the question earlier, and tell your name and ask the question. Yes? Any question?
No, sir.
Oh, you don't have to say no, sir. If you have a question, then you have to speak. Srijita, please see in the text windows, anybody have question? So the single linked list has come, then another way of single linked list, but we go for double linked list. It is better if you go for double linked list. Yes, double linked list. If you see the code, double linked list is here. Srijita, screen is visible? Just a minute.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The double linked list like this. Is a node value will be here. In earlier examples, here we first create a node, single node as a class type, create object of class, and then we create a whole object of single linked list. And this is a double linked list. Here we have a link. We can go from here to here and here to here, this is the link is there. What is the advantage of double link is that you can insert a delete with a O1 operation. But if you have a single link list, you have to deletion will be tough, insertion also will be tough. So here deletion will be very easy. You just if you have to delete C, you just put this one to here and this one to here. So single, so it is a faster, but it takes amount of space. So double link list is used many places. So I have taken the program from this Geeks for Geeks. You can see that program. Now I quickly go to the double link list program. So same here, I am creating a class node. You remember in earlier single link list you only have one value, and now one value and one pointer. Here we have one value and two pointers, self.previous, self.next. So that is only the class node. And you, how to create a class in Python, the class keyword, and this is, and if it is within a bracket something, that is a base class. I'll try to give example. This is a base class, this is not an extended class, and this is a constructor. How do you know it is a constructor? It is underscore int constructor means when the any object will be created, this code will be executed. Okay, so that is called constructor. So push, I am creating node new, these are the things, and it's just code will be available. And I pushing the value 714 and insert 8. So if you just run the code, creating double link list, so traversal in forward motion 4817, definitely whenever it go in reverse 7184. So I am creating here, see, I am creating here, see, new node. I'm always creating, this is a new node data, and I'm creating. Yeah, I'm pushing, say I am, if you pushing the data is like, say traditionally one, let's see, traditionally two, traditionally three, and traditionally the last data, say I am putting 9, and I just run the program once more. See here, in it is the data like traversal. So I have some done mistake, I have to shoot like this. Let's see it, where I think let's check. If I data put it correctly, no issue, it can be checked very easily. So I am here, yeah, so I am pushing 1, 2, 3, I am pushing here, say 4, better to be on 4, let's run, yeah, it is coming. Traversal in forward direction is 3421 and traversal in reverse direction 1243. May, might be I have done little mistake here, something 1234 should be. I think it can be corrected. I will show you in the corrected program. Anyway, what I want to show that these nodes are connected. This is the forward direction and this is the reverse direction. So you can traverse both way very fast. That is the usefulness of single link list, double link list. Okay, that is, and you can insert and delete a particular node very easily. And this is the code. And another thing I want to show you is a very easy thing here. That is yes. That is a selection sort. I think you all selection sort and insertion sort. Let's just check it. Selection sort. It is a selection sort, is a sorting algorithm. You know different kinds of sorting. One sorting technique is you compare each element with each element. That is always n element you are comparing with n minus 1 element. That is a sorting algorithm O n into n minus 1. That is the complexity is O n square. Those who are new to the programming, they must know what is the complexity of a program. That is very vital to get the completion time, and it should not depend on any language. So it should not depend on C, C++, Java, Python. So it depends on algorithm. So what is the concept of algorithm? Algorithm is nothing but steps. It is not a program. It is a steps you are taking, like whenever you are taking a calculation of GCD, what you are doing, that is the first algorithm by Euclid. So how to calculate GCD? So you divide one element by another, and certain things will be there in the quotient like this. So like this algorithm, you first try to get algorithm, and then you see the algorithm, whether it, you have to, how many steps you have to do. Like if you have a 1:n a loop, and within it another 1:n is loop, then your complexity is n square. Now we found a loop that 1:n, and within this loop you say divide and conquer, then you like Mars sort in binary search tree, you divide and conquer, then it will be log n, complexity will be log n to the base 2. So then Mars sort, if you see, is divide and conquer, and you will get the complexity in log n. But in binary, in bubble sort, in selection sort and insertion sort, you compare each element with each element, the complexity is n into n minus 1, it is n square. And n square algorithm, whenever n is more than 32, it's generally bigger than n log n. N log n algorithm is Mars sort, heap sort, these are the another also quick sort. Mostly it is n log n algorithm. So that is it. So selection sort is one of the worst algorithm in sorting, worse than bubble sort. So here I am putting a sorting here. So you can put any these numbers, I am putting it here, and this is your sorted array, it is coming up. What I am requesting to you, you have a definitely data structure classes. All the data structures programs, you can get it in Python. Just you Google search from GitHub, Git site, or various tutorials site. You can get a good Python program. You just copy paste and in your Google Colab sheet, and then your understanding will be, data structure will be better than, I believe, if you try it with C. Because whenever you try this kind of program in C, it will be definitely 50 lines program, and in Python maybe 7 or 8 lines. To understand 7 or 8 lines would be easier. So that understanding will help you to code in C also as well. So basic things is data structure, all the things are there in Python. You run it, then you do it. So this is a single linked list and sorting I have covered. So quickly show other things of Python. That is, I think it is already there, like object-oriented program that I have already discussed. I am creating a class, and whenever I am creating an object, that will be the constructor. How do you know constructor? If you know Java, the constructor name and class name will be the same. But here Python, it is underscore underscore init underscore. This is the same value. Sujita, why the noise is coming? Again, Anish Bose, want to outside. Nobody is deny entry. They create the problem. That is the thing. Okay. You must tell me, Sujita, why the noise is coming. Okay. You are only authorized to talk. Please. Okay. Second, this is a creation of problem. Have to ignore. Okay, so this is it. So I am creating a class, and this is a constructor. And what is this value? That is great in the Python. It is optional value. If you give any value, say anything else, then that will be overwrite. So you can create a class. As I here, object one I am creating with the just class name. Then if I do not give any value, then the 100 will be taken. And if I give any value 102, then 102 will be taken. You just run the code. The first I print object one dot count. So object one I didn't give any parameters. So it will take the default value 100. And here I give the value 102. So it is the printer. That's the great thing about Python. It is very obvious things can be happen, and you can see it. So that is one great thing here. Another is a small function like this: def test a comma b equal to 5, print a comma b. Here print test a b comma 5, b is equal to 5, print a b. Okay, so if I put test minus 3, that minus 3 is taken as a, and b is taken by 5. So whenever you see the automatically minus 3, 5 will be printed. So whenever you give minus 3 one value, minus 3 is go to a, and if you give, so that will be the printer. Okay, that is good thing. Or if I check it, minus 3 comma 6, yes, let's see what will be the printout. Yeah, it is takes minus 3 because now I give in value 6 instead of 5. So minus 3, 6 is coming. Okay, I think that is one great thing. Another thing I wish to show there is a power calculation. So I have defined a function power b comma p, and then y is equal to p. This is exponential p, return y, and def square x, I return square 2. So if we give n, so it is coming 9. I think it is obvious how to 3 squared 2 is 9. So another thing is I am creating a class student. So this is a constructor. I give the name here, this ID here. This is a student 1 Simon, and student 2 Kothika. This is one of the section A student, and this in the print name ID, name ID. If I run this code, Simon ID is 1, Kothika 2, and if I put it another value like student 3, here I say I put the value here Srijita. And ID is 3, then I just run the code. It is not printed because I have to give the print command this also. So I just copy it, copy selection, I put it here, Control V, and I put 3 here and 3 here, and just run the code. So Simon Kothika, it is there. So I think if you have, it's absolutely easy. If anything interesting comes, actually object oriented programming started by C++ in 1989 by Stroustrup, and everybody followed the C++ notation. Is one of the strongest C++ is the no one of the strongest languages. There's subtle variation with the C++. And because C++ is the, everybody copy C++, but they cannot copy the language. So certain things they have implemented. Like here, you don't have new operator. In Python, you have to just say the class. And Python, there are some overriding is done more obviously. So if you want to learn If you want to learn Python, just learn Python. Don't try to learn C++ first. Then everything will be confused because all the notations are very similar. Are you getting Pallo? So they have all copied it from C++. The best example of object-oriented programming Java, but and Python takes a mixture approach. It is taking C++ looks sometimes cryptic. Look, sometimes too Python took the obvious way, so that whenever you don't give any parameter, it will automatically take the parameter. Okay, so obvious parameters. So these are the novelty Python has make it, but basic thing is from taken from C++ with subtle changes. But if you want to learn C++ first and Python, then you will be confused at the Python. So it is better to learn from the Python itself. So any books, any site, you can get it. I also mentioned where it is different. Like I told you, in C++ you have to have new operator, in Java you have a new operator, but here no new operator. You have to just tell the class name again, the object will be created. In C++ you have a public, private, protected. Here you don't have this type of confusion. Okay, so C++ like this. Okay, C++ construct of Java, the constructor should have the same name, but here you don't. You have a __init__. So there are very subtle changes, but the concept is same. Okay, so I'll get back to your question. Python is a dictionary. What is dictionary? Dictionary is totally not there in Java and C. Dictionary, it is how to detect with the dictionary. It is because not for dig. It is object name. The second bracket opening and second bracket closing, that is the indication where it is a set or dictionary. When it's a dictionary, you have a comma separated value, comma, and within these two values. So this is key and this is the value. This is key, this is value. First of all, any dictionary is a mutable. So in a dictionary, you can add element, you can delete an element, it's a mutable. And in a dictionary, the left hand side should be key. There should be one value of the key. You cannot have a duplicate values. These values can be duplicate. And third restriction is the keys should be immutable. Like keys should be any number, any string. These are immutable. Unlike C, and it can be tuple. You know, tuple is immutable, and it can be frozen set. And here anything can be there. It's immutable, immutable. So I initialize a dictionary like lion, wild, tiger, wild, cat. See, here wild can duplicate, but here it cannot because this is a key values. Cat domestic, dog domestic, and print dictionary. I am just doing it. So that's the value, and if you can delete the dictionary by the key value is tiger, so it will be automatically deleted. So next this value, it will be automatically deleted. So I am taking another dictionary here. Say key value A, 1, B, 2, print length of dictionary. This is a function of the dictionary. Of this length is the inbuilt function. It will give the length. Here is length is 3. Then print get P. I want to know what is the value. And dictionary I have initialized. So if you just see it. If I run the code, so length is 3. That is the 3 is coming. Dict 1 get P. What is the value of B? It is 2 is coming. And I am dictionary A, I am adding a value. I change the value with 5 instead of 1. So right now A is good. Okay. So first of all, I must say, don't fear Python. Python is the easiest of the language. In fact, people who hate programming, they start loving programming by Python. Python is a great, great language. It's because if you want to learn C++, C, it is very tough to learn. Syntax is very tough. You have to look out for the ID like this. Python ID is everywhere available, particularly Google, any place, and it run the programs. You can have a graphics, you can there, machine learning there, everything you can do in Python. Development time is quicker, so you love programming by Python. And you don't have to write everything from scratches. You just copy the code and paste it and run it, and then try to understand and do the design modification. That is the way to learn Python. Happy Pythoning. So any question?